In this video, we will be learning about how to apply conditional formatting. So first of all, in whichever cells we have to apply the conditional formatting, first we have to select those cells. So let's say I want to highlight the percentage 90 and above. So I will just select the percentage from here, all the percentage, then in this option of conditional formatting, I will just click on this small arrow over here, and then I will click on the new rule option. As soon as I click on the new rule, I will get this new formatting rule window. I just have to select on the second option, that is format only cells that contain. Now on the basis of cell value, I have to highlight the cells. So I will just from the drop down, by default cell value is selected. So cell value only will have to keep. Then I want the values equal to or greater than 90. So greater than or equal to, I will select this option. And then I will type 90 over here. Then I will just go to the format option. The format cells window will open. In this, I have to choose the fill option. So in this fill option, I have to select the color from which color I want to highlight. So we can also choose from more colors, the standard version and the custom version. So whatever color we want to choose, we can choose that color and then we can click on OK. And again, we have to click on OK and then this window also OK. So now you can see that automatically I can see 95.83 is highlighted and 90.83 is highlighted. So this is how we can highlight the cells based on conditional formatting. Now in this percentage itself, if I want to highlight the students who are getting percentage below 33. So for that, again, I will select these cells. And again, I will go to this conditional formatting. Now, another way is I can again go to the new rule and I can just set cell value, cell that contain cell value. Then I can select less than and then I can type 33 over here. I can just go to format and just choose a color. Okay. So now all the cells with percentage less than 33% are highlighted. So two students we can see are there who have scored less than 33%. Now if I want to remove the conditional formatting, so I just have to select the complete sheet. I don't know in whichever sheet or cell is there. So if from the complete sheet I want to delete, then I can just select the complete sheet. I can go to the conditional formatting arrow and then clear rules, second option, clear rules from the entire sheet. If I apply this option, then the entire sheet, if it is containing any conditional formatting, then it will be removed. So if from particular area, let's say from this area only I want to remove. So I will just select these cells over here. I will click on conditional formatting, clear rules and clear rules from the selected cells. So this way the rules will be removed from only this column. Another way of applying conditional formatting is I will just select these cells and then I will go to conditional formatting. Highlight cell rules. Now highlight cell rules, I want greater than. So I will click on greater than. Greater than, let's say 90. Greater than 90 over here. So now in this drop down, I will see that I am having by default, some of the formatting options are here only. So I can select amongst these options, like you can see the color is changing, and if I'm not satisfied with the options, I can go to the custom format option. then I can just select the desired color, the fill color, and the font color. It is showing maroon over here. I can just change it to black and OK. And then click on OK. So now this is also another way of highlighting the cells. Here, predefined settings are there, like greater than, less than, between, equal to. So these predefined rules are already given. So top 10 items, above average. So all these options are there. And if we don't find the option that is required, then we can create a new rule from here. Now, if I want to edit any rule, then I have to click on manage rule. Let's say I want to change the color. So I will just select this and go to edit rule. And I can change the color from here. I'll go to fill and I can just change the color. Okay. And okay. So now the color has changed. Now this is the formatting we are applying only on a cell. If we want to highlight an entire row based on a particular cell value, let's say I want to highlight the complete row where the students have scored less than 33%. So in that case, what I will do, I will select the table from where the values are starting. I will not select the heading because in that case, I will get error. So I will just start selecting from where my values are starting and I will select the complete table. So this is my complete table where I want to apply the conditional formatting. Then again, I will go to this arrow over here, conditional formatting. I will click on new rule. Now, here I will choose the last option. Use a formula to determine which cells to format. Then, after this, I will click on this box over here where it is written format values where this formula is true. So, I will just click over here and this arrow. I'll click on this arrow and then I will select the first cell over here. The percentage, wherever the first cell I'm getting, I will select this. Then again, I will click on this arrow. So now it is written $K, $9. So $K, $9 means that K column will be static. So I want the K column to be static, but 9 I don't want static because values are in 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and so on. So $K it will be there, 9. Then with the mouse I will click next to 9 and I will write less than 33. So K column, whatever values are there, that has to be less than 33. Then the formatting will be applied. So again, I will click on format over here, choose the color. I go to more colors, then this custom. I'll just lighten the shade. Okay. Then I'll just click on okay over here. Okay. So now you can see that the entire row 31.67% and 30%. So two students are there who have scored less than 33%. So this is how we can apply the conditional formatting. Let's say I just remove this clear from the entire sheet. Now what happens if I'm going to select the headings also? This is the common mistake that we all do. So if we are just selecting the heading also along with this, we go to the conditional formatting, we go to the new rule, use a formula to determine which cells to format. Here I will click the first value over here instead of this dollar that is appearing over here with the 9. I will just remove it and I will just type less than 33, go to the format option, more colors, custom, choose the color, choose the shade, okay. Then I'll click on okay, okay. Now you see that the error that is coming over here is that This is the value 63.33. Still, we can see that it is highlighted. So, because some values of these it is considering, or some other value it is considering. So, we should, while selecting the conditional formatting cells, we should be very particular about it. Any extra cells should not be included. My data is in this part only. Even these rows that are here, the subject wise, min, max, these are even not required in my conditional formatting. So only and only the area that is required, only the cell value that are required in my formula, only those values we are going to include. Any extra value we are not going to include, because that might hamper the formula. Like we can see over here, we have selected heading. So because of this, we are not getting the correct result. So this was all about conditional formatting. Thank you.